get him away from the house, get somebody to look at him, push him, you know, away from the house.
Golf carts are catching fire all over Southwest Florida in the month since Hurricane Ian. We reported on this one in Charlotte County, and then dozens of them caught fire on Sanibel Island back in October.
So we sent NBC2's Samantha Serban to find out why this continues to happen.
It comes down to the battery packs inside the golf cart and if they were exposed to salt water during Hurricane Ian. Here at Matt's Custom Carts, their battery packs are in a waterproof box, but other brands may not have been back in late September.
Black smoke billowing into the sky with an orange glow underneath. It's becoming an all too familiar sight for golf cart owners.
Especially after with the hurricane, with having Ian and everything, that's a problem that we're running into with a lot of the EVs, a lot of the electric vehicles.
For our folks living on the barrier islands, it's not hard to find the culprit.
We believe it's created by electrolysis, the salt water entering the battery packs and creating issues within the battery.
Back in September, Hurricane Ian sent water well over the roofs of many golf carts in places like Sanibel and Fort Myers Beach, burying the batteries.
That can create some pretty significant problems. It just causes things to degrade a lot faster.
The salt in the water is mending with the electronics in the cart and creating connectivity in the battery, and that's what's causing fires.
Matt Bucci owns Matt's Custom Carts in Southern Charlotte County. All of his batteries were kept dry by waterproof containers, but he can't promise that for others outside his shops.
I recommend if the cart was submerged underwater, get it away from the home. Have somebody check it out. Somebody needs to open up the battery pack and check it out.
You know, one phone call away could save them a lot of problems.
This shouldn't be a problem if your golf cart was flooded by fresh water or just covered with rain. But to avoid any chance at sparking flames,
the most important thing is to use the right charger. Use the chargers that are provided for them in the manner that they're prescribed to be used. Follow the manufacturer's recommendations to charge those in a well-ventilated area.
Here's a lesson you need to take away today. If your golf cart was submerged in salt water, take it to a professional ASAP. I'm local today in Charlotte County. Samantha Serban, NBC2.